So I'm going to turn the microphone over to Manny.
Hi, everyone. First, I would like to thank God for a successful event tonight. And I want to thank the press and media for always there to support us. And of course, I want to thank you, Bob Arum, Top Arum Promotion, for helping me since the beginning. And of course, I don't want to forget to thank the MGM. You know, I have a lot of fight here in MGM. Thank you for hosting the fight here in MGM. A lot of my fights. So thank you so much for all the support and all the sponsors always there behind us to support every promotion, not only my fight but to the other fights. Of course, thank you to the team pacquiao, Freddy Rhodes, and the rest. Of course, the team Bradley. Thank you for a good fight tonight. Thank you.
Here we go, right here.
Any questions?
Manny, does this feel like the end to you, or did you do some things tonight where you're encouraged to keep this thing going?
Repeat the question. Let him get his mic.
No problem. Does this feel like the end to you? Congratulations, by the way. Does this feel like the end to you, and were there some good things that happened for you that will occur, or will, you know, you be encouraged to return?
Like I said, sir, I already decided that, and committed to my family that after this fight, I'm going to get back home and spend more time with them. And they took about retirement that going to be. And focus to help the people, serve the people in the Philippines. And that's my priority right now and focus.
Manny, hi. You said the other day you dreamed about how this fight would turn out. Did it turn out the way you dreamed?
Well, I'm happy with the result of the fight tonight. Although, you know, every round I'm looking for a knockout to finish the fight, but we know that Bradley is also a top opponent, top boxer. So, you know, I did my best, but I'm so happy with that. It's so did that almost what I want to do.
So let me just make sure I got it right. You dreamed you were going to knock Bradley out? Was that the dream that you knocked Bradley out to win? Or
that's, you know, I tell you this, every round I'm looking for a good shot and I'm looking for a knockout. But like I said, Bradley is not that easy opponent.
Hey Manny, right here. Does it, you know, you say you're retired, but wouldn't it be, you know, better for the Filipino people if you continue to fight because their spirits seem to be lifted by you?
You know, let me enjoy first a retired life. If you ask me about come back, I don't know because I might enjoy a retired life, and like I said, and to say to coming back. I'm not there yet, so I don't know what's the feeling. You know, I don't know what's the feeling. And I'm committing to my family that, you know, I made my decision. So, thank you. Although, if you ask me about my condition, about my body is still, I'm still okay. I can still give a good fight, 100% condition like that. About training, I'm not busy in training, I work hard in training, so I'm still okay. Freddy knows that how I prepare for the fight.
Go ahead,
Manny,
I just wonder, like, what it is that you love about boxing? What was it that brought you to the gym every day? Was it the fight itself, or was it the camaraderie with Freddie and working with all your training partners that you love?
Just it's a mix. I like the fight. I love the way we prepare for the fight. It's just I'm happy doing that preparing for every fight. So and Freddie, he always saw that to me, the aggressiveness, the hungerness, and the training to work hard. He knows how I work.
Manny, right here. Two questions. One, in the eighth round, Tim got you with a good left hook, and then you were on the ropes, and you clinched with him, and then you whispered something to him. Can you tell us what you said?
Well, I did that intentionally, so that he would come out and I can counter him, and then I can counter him, and then I won that. But when I counter him again and throwing other punches, throwing power punches, he started back off like that and moving around, so it didn't work.
But what did you say to him? You whispered something to him. What can you tell us what you said?
Whisper? I said it's a break.
And the second question, you seem to be having a lot of fun in here tonight, you know, smiling, touching your gloves together. Can you tell us how much fun you had in there tonight, maybe compared to some of your more recent fights?
Like I said, it's a good thing it's happened to me that I have a long layout in boxing. You know, what I feel tonight, I feel like fresh. You know, that's why every round, I'm excited. I feel fresh. Like, I remember when I started boxing, when I started fighting here in America, 2001. So that's my feeling.
Manny, did you have any problems with your shoulder? Your right hand? Any problems with your right shoulder tonight?
No. I'm really thankful to God that he, you know, the healing is really fast and recovery. And tonight, you know, I want to use it to prove that it's healed already. But when I get him a few right hook, then he's back off. And, you know, he feel it. And then he knows that I'm going to counter him and right off.
One last question. Do you think you ended this trilogy as friends? As friends with Bradley?
Did you end the trilogy as friends?
Yeah, Bradley is a nice he's a nice guy, a good man, you know. In fact, I invited him to tomorrow with our Bible study. He'll try tomorrow to come to Bible study. This is good. I mean, this is boxing. We don't need to hit each other outside the ring. We should be friends. And, you know, we entertain people. We give exciting fight for the people. That's our job.
Manny, right over here.
Perfect.
It sounds like your family wants you to retire more than you want to retire. Can you definitely say tonight that you'll never fight again?
You're good, huh? My heart is 50-50, you know. My heart is 50-50, but I love my family, I honor my family, you know, my kids. I encourage them not to go in boxing, to be a boxer. One day, because boxing is a really hard sport and very difficult. And I don't know, like I said, you know, I might enjoy my as a retired life, or am I gonna come back? It's hard to say because I'm not there yet, you know. But right now, I my decision is to retire.
If Mayweather came back, would you change your mind?
I can't answer that because, like I said, I might enjoy retired life, you know, spend more time with my family and helping people, you know, I love to help people. And even before, from the beginning, before I became a politician, I'm helping people in my country. Because, you know why? Because